today. We have a collection of six huntsmen at the front of the huge collection house. One hound, horses, and second hounds. We're waiting to see what happens now, ladies and gentlemen. We're just waiting to see now, ladies and gentlemen, what can possibly happen.
One of the hounds is doing this.
You hear a thrilling piercing horn. I see someone's got a point on the far side of the ring. Whether he's seen anything, I don't know. And the huntsman's doubling his horn. In fact, several huntsmen are now going to double their horn.
I can see that.
Yes, he's taking shoulder with some hedging now, so whether he's going to be safe, I don't know. He's slowing down. But still, remorselessly, the mass pack presses on. The fox is waving, whether in desperation or excitement. Is very happy.
Oh, look at that shoulder. Oh, that fox's
maybe it doesn't mean much for them. But there you are, ladies and gentlemen, a wonderful display from six packs from Surrey, Kent and Sussex. They're going forward now to take the salute from the joint presidents of the show, Mr. Brian Perrin and Mrs. Jane Perrin, joint presidents, and they're going to take the salute from all the mounted packs. Quite a remarkable event this, because one of the two presidents, Brian Perrin, is also the president of the Old Surrey First Show of West Kent Hounds. And I think it's probably the first time that we've had a president of a pack of hounds and at the same time president of the show. So congratulations to everybody for bringing it this afternoon. We take the hats off to the president acknowledges them in return. Brian Perrin, one president, not only now president of the Old Surrey, but in the past, was a very gallant master of the Old Surrey Hounds. He and his wife are now coming forward to meet the mountain head staff.
Actually. Yeah, visiting sick relatives. Stinky, stinky.
I'm a dreamer.
You can tell the difference
from the
people out there.
Oh, the little ones.
They say. Hunting will live till our sons are gone. Sons of our grandsons, ride the king. The flash of scarlet on England's green. If you ride the earth in 100 years and look at the land through a horse's ears, you'll see the fields and you see them now. The foxhounds feathering over the plough. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what we're going to be doing. If we win a government of power, we will repeal the Hunting Act. So we will pay closely at
the
election.
I get a few votes, but I agree. Have you heard the joke doing the rounds about Gordon Brown being a bit worried about his legacy and deciding on various things? And one of the things he might do is to have a restored steam engine named after him. Have you heard this one? So he rings up the steam engine restoration trust and says, have you got any in the block? Sorry, we haven't got anyone coming through, but there is one we would like to restore. Yeah, if you gave us the story, we'd happily call it the Gordon Brown.
Until last season,
you annoy the Prime Minister, you may find that we've started to be a charitable state a bit. This really gets up there, doesn't it?
No.
It's so funny, they get so better when they ring back. They say, well, actually, we found an existing locomotive that we could actually rename. And all we've got to do is just drop the first letter of the name and it'll be suitable. And he said, what is it? Well, he says, it's a very famous engine. Actually, it's a green one.
We're committed to display this afternoon.